least, even experts who've been critical of President Trump in the past, like Tom Friedman, call it a major breakthrough.
Criticized the vice president calling out Antifa and other left-wing extremist groups to condemn white supremacists and militia groups and to say that they need to stand down and not add to the violence in a number of these cities, as we saw in Kenosha and as we've seen in Portland.
You want to call them? What do you want to call them? Give me a name. Give me a
white
name.
Supremacists and right,
like me to condemn
white supremacists and right proud militia.
Boys. Stand back and stand by, but I'll tell you what, somebody's got to do something about Antifa and the left.
If any of you have ever seen the movie The Purge, you're going to recognize the sound.
Bro, what the heck, man? They coming around again.
This blaring sound startled many in the small town of Crowley, Louisiana.
All of a sudden, you just hear The Purge, which is going, you know, I know it's famous right now. It just caused a lot of havoc, a lot of chaos. You hear the sirens blaring. They're just super loud. My dog freaks out. Neighbors coming outside, checking out what was going on, yelling, just upset about it.
The police sounding an alarm to signify the start of curfew. From 9 at night to 6 in the morning, Crowley residents must remain at home.
Shots fired, shots fired.
Officer down.
Officer down, they're backing officers out.
Take cover.
Officer down. Take cover.
I don't know if you know this. And I don't know if you're going to believe me when I tell you this. But what's happening right now in America is witchcraft trying to take this country over. It's witchcraft. It's trying to take America back over.
Listen to the word of the Lord. God says, I will put at your helm for two terms. A president that will pray, but he will not be a praying president when he starts.
Mr. Kushner, I want to ask you about foreign policy priorities for a second term for the Trump administration. What would they be?
So, look, for the first 4 years, President Trump has what I would call, he's definitely harvested a lot of accomplishments, but he's also set the table. He's definitely harvested a lot of accomplishments, but he's also set the table. And I think that what you have now is a situation where there's tremendous possibilities.
Trump shall become a trumpet, says the Lord.
I, Donald John Trump, do solemnly swear.
Who has heard the poem called The Snake?
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
So here it is, the snake. It's called the snake. Down the path. You knew damn well I was a snake before you took me in.
So help me God.
My number one priority in the coming 2 months is to try to facilitate a transition that ensures our president-elect is successful.
On the White House transition,
helping us to make America great again.
Well, we have a lot of priorities. The priority we have is a priority for the country and bringing it back. I use the expression transition to greatness, but it's a transition.
The transition to greatness has officially begun.
Remember that. Your heads will spin.
Your head will spin. His head would spin.
That your head will spin. Folks, your head's gonna spin. Spin.
We handed him a booming economy. He blew it.
What? How exactly are you going to negotiate that? What magic wand do you have?
If you remember, President Obama, you need a magic wand. No, you don't.
You cannot sit back and wait for a savior.
Somebody had to do it. I am the chosen one.
We don't need a messiah.
And I believe that one way or the other after the election, they're going to have to make a deal. And I think that President Trump, if he's the winner, I think he'll make the right deal that will help stabilize the region.
There's about to be a shift, and the deep state is about to manifest, and it's going to be a showdown like you can't believe.
I would say almost everything I see is from the left wing, not from the right wing. This is not a right wing problem. This is a left wing.
FBI director.
This is a left wing problem.
I supported the president's strike, but I am very leery of a large military operation in Syria, and I think Democrats and Republicans in Congress share that view.
Well, politics is defined by the geographical and influential spheres of this country. It's irrelevant to black people, and it's irrelevant to the masses of people. The vote has been used as a tool of oppression. There is no choice. Evil is evil. There's nothing in between it.
Every year, I get the call, California's burning. California's burning. There shouldn't be that problem. I spoke with the governor about it. I'm getting along very well with the governor. But I said, at some point, you can't every year have hundreds of thousands of acres of land just burned to the ground. Burning down because of a lack of management.
But sir, a few other animals have perished either directly or indirectly as a result of those fires.
And because of the fires, could be moving closer to extinction.
Work together with that science. That science is going to be key, because if we ignore that science and sort of put our head in the sand and think it's all about vegetation management, we're not going to succeed together protecting Californians.
Okay. It'll start getting cooler.
You just watch. I wish science agreed with you.
Hey, well, I don't think science knows, actually.
Was done by people in our own government and our own banking system to perpetuate the fear of the American people into subordinating themselves to anything the government wants them to do.
Bin Laden had been not only a symbol of terrorism, but a mass murderer who's had eluded justice for so long, and so many families who had been affected, I think, had given up hope. And for us to be able to definitively say, we got the man who caused thousands of deaths here in the United States was something that I think all of us were profoundly grateful to be a part of.
New York, look what they're doing in New York, what they're doing to our beautiful New York. Oh, it's so sad.
You know, and until we discover what really happened on 9/11 and who was responsible for 9/11, because that's where the war on terror emanates from. That's where it comes from. It was 9/11 that allowed this war on terror to begin. And until we get to the bottom root of 9/11, the truth of 9/11, we'll never know about the war on terror.
Are they tied to biblical prophecy, blood moon eclipses?
That's what it's about, and to create this war, this endless war on terror. And that's why we, and that was the first lie. And the next lie was going into Iraq, you know, to get Saddam Hussein out with his weapons of mass destruction. That was the next lie.
What President Trump has done here is unthinkable. He's brought people in the Middle East together. There's been these barriers that have existed that have led to so much instability, so much war, so much loss, so much hopelessness, and we're seeing so much hopefulness now coming. Things are really starting to move in a really strong direction, and this makes America safer. It allows us to bring our troops home, and allows us to work on bringing prosperity to American communities. So really, thank you for your leadership.
Thank
congratulations
you,
on this great success.
Great job. Thank you very much, dear.
And there was a lot of blame to go around, but you, Mr. Trump, recognized that the real problem was a lack of leadership. And so ultimately, you didn't blame Little John or Meatloaf. You fired Gary Busey. And these are the kind of decisions that would keep me up at night.
One chapter in history, and we begin another.
Well handled, sir. Well handled.
This is not a testament to me, but a testament to all of the people who believed real change, not Obama change, but real change is possible.
Say what you will about Mr. Trump, he certainly would bring some change to the White House.
But I'll tell you what they don't want. They don't want a population of citizens capable of critical thinking. They don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking. They're not interested in that.
It's such a massive time of change and enlightenment.
These traditions are correct in believing that it serves as the connecting link between the physical and spiritual worlds.
I believe that it is important for all of us, regardless of party, and regardless of political preferences, to now come together, work together, to deal with the many challenges that we face.
Scientific proof that's backing up that spiritual enlightenment comes from our pineal gland, known as the third eye, and depicted as ancient as the seat of the soul.
Tripping on the